您现在收看的是华视教育文化频道，
接下来要播出的是英文文法与修辞一。
各位同学大家好，欢迎收看英文文法与修辞第七讲次。我们这个礼拜要谈的是指示代名词、不定代名词、疑问代名词、关系代名词以及相互代名词。以下是我们的讲次目标。我们的讲次目标是要为同学探讨英文代名词它的系统与分类，我们还要分析指示代名词、不定代名词、疑问代名词、关系代名词以及相互代名词它的定义、功能和用法。下面是我们的摘要。 A， 指示代名词是指出所谈及的事物以及讲话者他之间的位置的远近关系，包括 this， 这是单数指说和讲话者位置相当接近， these 是复数和讲话者的位置也是很近，可是 that 的话是单数，是指说和讲话者的位置比较远，那 those 是复数，与讲话者的位置比较远。 B，不定代名词代表不特定的事或人，那包括像 all、 any、 anyone、 anything、 each、 everyone、 everything、 several、 some、 someone、 something 这些。 C 的话是疑问代名词，它是用来提出问题，包括像 what、 which、 who、 whom、 whose 这些。D 是关系代名词，它是用来引介和先行词相关的子句，包括说 which、 who、 whom、 whose、 that 等等。那这个 E 最后的是包括相互代名词，像 each other、 one another 这两个哈，是用来表达两个人或是多人以上他们彼此相互的关系。好，下面我们要请美国老师 Steven 老师帮我们来朗读课文。
In this lecture, we are going to learn English demonstrative pronouns, indefinite pronouns, interrogative pronouns, relative pronouns, and reciprocal pronouns. The demonstrative pronouns include this, that, these, and those. This and these, which is the plural of this,are used to indicate things that are near to the speaker. That and those are used to indicate things that are at some distance from the speaker. The following are some examples. This is my wallet and that is yours. These are my candies and those are yours. Indefinite pronouns refer to unspecific people or things,which include all, any, anyone, anything, several, some, someone, and something. The following are some examples. You can fool all of the people some of the time, and some of the people all of the time, but you cannot fool all of the people all of the time. Since there are no specific persons or times involved, the indefinite pronouns all and someare used here. I will grant you three wishes. Tell me anything you want. I love you so much that I will do anything for you. Since there is no specific thing mentioned here, the indefinite pronoun anything is used. interrogative pronouns such as what, which, who, whom, whose are used to ask questions. The following are some examples. What do you do? What does your father do? What does your mother do? Which do you prefer, coffee or tea? Who is speaking?Whom do you like? Where are you going? I'm going home. Where are you going? I'm going to the library. Whose wallet is this? Relative pronouns include which, who, whom, whose, and that. A relative pronoun is used to connect one phrase or clause to another phrase or clause.The relative pronouns who and whoever are used to refer to the subject of a clause or sentence. Whom and whomever to refer to the objects of a verb or a preposition. In other words, who is used to refer to people in the subjective case, whom is used in the objective case, which is used to refer to things,That is used to refer to people and things. The following are some examples. This is the girl who won the book award. The relative pronoun who introduces a relative clause and has reference to the antecedent the girl. This is the necklace which I bought last month. The relative pronoun which here is used to refer to the necklace. The novel that you gave me was really interesting. The relative pronoun that here is used to refer to the novel. Reciprocal pronouns include each other and one another. When there are two or more people involved, we will use either each other or one another to show a reciprocal relationship.The following are some examples. My students help each other with their assignments. United we stand. We should help one another to go through difficulties.
谢谢 Steven 老师。接下来我来为同学讲解课文。In this lecture, 这个讲次里面 we are going to learn English demonstrative pronouns. 我们要学英文的指示代名词 indefinite pronouns 不定代名词 interrogative pronouns 疑问代名词 relative pronouns 关系代名词以及 reciprocal pronouns 相互代名词 The demonstrative pronouns include this, that, these, and those 这指示代名词包括This 这啊 ，that 那一个 ，these 是这些 ，those 是那些哈 ，this and these 是 plural of this 是 this 的复数 ，are used to indicate things that are near to the speaker。那这两个 this 跟 these， 它是用来标明出来事情哈就。谈及的事情是跟 speaker 比较接近距离近距离 that and those 那和那些 are used to indicate things that are at some distance from the speaker 那和那些它是标明说讲话者和他指的这些东西哈有一些距离 the following are some examples 下面我们举些例子This is my wallet. 这是我的皮夹。That is yours. 那是你的。These are my candy. 那这些是我的糖果。And those are yours. 那些是你的。好，我们现在休息一下，待会再继续。现在是 indefinite pronouns 不定代名词它指的是 refer to 指的是 unspecific people 不特定的人 or things 或是事情 which include 那包括有 all 所有 any 任何一个或是 anyone 任何一个人 anything 任何事情 several 有几个 some 有一些 someone 某个人 something 某件事那下面是一些例子哈 You can fool all of the people some of the time你可以欺骗愚弄 fool 是欺骗愚弄所有的人某一些的时间那 some of the people 或者是哈某一些人 all of time 所有的时间你都可以骗得到他们 but you cannot fool all of the people all of time 可是你不能欺骗所有的人愚弄所有的人所有的时间哈 since there are no specificperson or time involved 因为这个句子里面我们没有指出来特定的人或特定的时间所以我们用 all 和 some 所有和某些那下面的句子 I'll grant you three wishes 我会允诺你三个愿望就是你要许三个愿我可以帮你完成 tell me anything you want 告诉我任何你想要的事情I love you so much that I will do anything for you. 啊，我真爱你哈。然后你想要什么事情，做什么事情，我都一定帮你做。Since there's no specific thing, 这边哈没有提到特定的这个事情 ，mention 就提到哈，没有提到特定的事情。那 the indefinite pronoun 不定。代名词 anything 任何的事情就 anything 就用这个字了哈下面我们谈的是 interrogative pronoun 疑问代名词像是 what which who whom 还有 whose 这些是用来提问题的那下面有一些例子像 what do you do 我们基本上问人家说哈你做什么工作哈 what do you do 那底下是一个 pattern 一个句型练习 What does your father do? 你也可以说你父亲是从事什么工作呢 What does your mother do? 你母亲是做什么呢然后另外一个是 Which do you prefer? 你想要哪一样东西下面就举出来说 Coffee or tea 中间选一个那另外一个疑问代名词像 Who Who is speaking 通常接电话的我们接传接电话说 Who's speaking 是谁呀然后 Whom do you like 这边是说你喜欢哪个人然后 Where are you going 你要去哪里 I'm going home 我要回家那另外这句型练习可以说 Where are you going 你可以讲说 I'm going to the library 我要去图书馆啊或去电影院都可以 Who's 下面这 Who's 疑问代名词其实就是说你看到任何东西假如说看到个钱包 whose wallet 只要讲 whose 谁的呢这是谁的 好下面 relative pronoun 这个我们讲说关系代名词包括 which who whom whose that 这些那 a relative pronoun 关系代名词它怎么用呢是 used to 用来是 connect one phrase or clause 我们要把它一个句子片语或是子句把它 connect to another phrase or clause 把它连到另外一个片语或是子句那 the relative pronoun 这个疑问代名这个、关系代名词像 who and whoever 它用来是指的这个 subject of the of a clause or sentence 记住 who 或是 whoever 这个 who 是指的是 subject 是主格一个子句或是句子它的主词叫 who 那 whom 的话或 whomever 是要指的是受格通常是一个动词或介系词后面就要用 whom whomever 受格所以我们一再强调英文一定有主格受格一定要分清楚那 in other words 就是我们换句话来说 who 它是用来指的是 people In the subjective case 这个 who 是用来指人 而且是主格，就是主词的地位。Whom 是用来指人，可是它是受格的地位，所以主格受格英文是分得很清楚。Which 它用来指的是事情，所以事情绝对不能用 who， 它一定要用 which。 那下面这个 that 它可以用来指人也可以指事情，所以你不确定的时候，有时候 背不清楚的时候，你就直接用 that 好了，人跟事都可以用。那我们下面来为同学举一些例子，像 This is the girl who won the book award， 就这个女孩是什么，是什么女孩，是她赢得了书卷奖，就成绩很好，书卷奖，我们就是 book award。 那 the relative pronoun 就是这个关系代名词 who， 它是来引进 introduce 引进一个 relative clause， 就是关系子句，然后它 has reference to the antecedent， 它就指前面这个女孩， who 就是指这个女孩 the girl， 你 the girl 后面就直接用 who， 就是指前面的这个。 This is the necklace，就是这个 necklace 是指项链哈，然后后面这个 which， 这 which 就是指前面的 necklace。 这个项链什么项链呢，是 which I bought last month， 这个项链是我上个月买的。那 relative pronoun which 关系代名词哈，这边是用来 refer to the necklace which， 我们刚强调哈，这 which 是指前面的 necklace。The novel that you gave me was really interesting。 然后这本小说，然后用 that， 我们讲说凡是物或人都可以用 that， 这本小说你给我的这本小说非常有趣。 The relative pronoun that here is used to refer to the novel， 这边这个 that 这个关系代名词就是指前面这个 novel。 好，再过来 reciprocal pronouns，相互代名词，它有两个，一个是 each other， one another， 就是彼此哈。那当我们有两个或是两个以上的人谈及两个或两个以上人彼此互相怎么样，这时候 either 我们不是用 each other， 就是用 one another 哈，来 show 显示一个 reciprocal relationship， 显示一个相互的一个关系。那我们下面举例给同学看。 My students help each other with their assignment， 我的学生通常彼此都互相帮忙，就是给他的作业功课同学都一起做，互相帮忙。再过来 United we stand， 这就是说团结就是力量 United we stand。 We should help one another to go through difficulty， 我们应该彼此互相帮忙。Go through difficulty， 就是说解决难题，解决困难。
One demonstrative，
这个 demonstrative 这个字是语言学里面指示的。像我们课文里面提到说 this 还有 these， 这个跟这些，然后距离远一点是 that 跟 those， 那个那些。
Two interrogative，
这 interrogative 是指疑问的，我们这边 interrogative pronoun 疑问代名词里面包括像 who 谁，然后 which 哪一个，像 which do you like， 就做一个选择哈，你到底喜欢谁呢，喜欢哪一个，选择性的 what 什么这些哈。
Three reciprocal，
reciprocal 我们这边也是我们文法跟语言学里面用，这 reciprocal 是彼此互相的，通常是 each other 跟 one another 彼此互相怎么样。
Four indicate
Indicate 这个字经常用，还有考试不管你考任何研究所呀，或是入学考试，还有托福多益，这个字经常出现，就显现出来或是指示。 我们这边讲说指示显现 indicate 显现出什么
5. Unspecific
好这个 unspecific 它是指不明确的不过我们可以把这个字拆开来看一下这个 spec 通常是指说看 spec specific specific 是形容词它假如要变成动词的话就变成 specify 凡是 fy 就变成动词好我们这个形容词哈记住它前面加了 un 加了 un 本来 specific 是指明确的非常明确的特别指出来加上一个 un 以后就变成不明确所以这个 un 在英文里面是经常使用的一个否定像我们讲说 important 很重要加上 un 以后就变成 unimportant 好非常多的字你记住只要加上 un 就变成负面否定的意思
6. Mention
好提到提及说起
7. Reference
Reference 这边有当作参考还有通常我们讲说你人家要你那个去找工作的话要有 reference letter 就是人家给你的介绍信这些
8. Antecedent
这个 antecedent 是语言学里面专门用文法里面专门用就是指前面的先行词
9. Involved
Involved 就是相关的就是彼此牵扯在内的就是 involved
10. Assignment
Assignment 这个字我们可以拆开来看 Assign A-S-S-I-G-N 这个字 Assign 就是动词那动词变成名词它的语尾变化很重要一个就是加上 M-E-N-T 不止这个字非常多的这个字都是后面动词后面加上 ment 就变成转换词类就变成名词这边讲说任务工作这动词的话就是 I'll assign you this task 我给你这个任务你讲 assign 就是一个动词可是你讲说 what assignment did you get 这时候就变成只要加上 ment 就马上转换词类变成名词接下来的话是我们的 chat room We'll continue our talk on the pronouns demonstrative, indefinite, interactive, relative, and reciprocal pronouns. Could you that compare that to those in Chinese language and also in English language?
The important difference between Chinese and English with regard to interrogative pronouns is that in Chinese, interrogative pronouns normally go.In what the general grammar would claim is their normal position. If an interrogative pronoun is a subject, then it goes before the verb. If it's an object, it goes after the verb. In English, on the other hand, interrogative pronouns normally go at the beginning of the clause, no matter where they may be coming from, no matter where they may belong, in terms of the strict grammar. So, what did you do? Not you did what.
Right, right.
When did you see? Whom did you see in the park yesterday? Not you saw whom in the park yesterday. Which car did my wife buy in May? Not my wife bought which car in May.
OK, 好谢谢 Steven 老师。基本 Steven 老师帮我们做一个比较。中文跟英文我们都有这个代名词。可是一个很重要的差别是中文的代名词它通常主词的时候我们讲说谁在发言。那动词是发言谁是主词这个主词是谁在发言。主词的时候它就在动词的前面就是中文英文中文它的文法是主词动词受词那假如是你在做什么这个什么是做什么做是一个动词什么是一个受词所以假如它是受词的时候它就在动词的后面中文假如是它是一个主词的话它就在 动词的前面是受词的话，就在动词的后面，这是中文的语法。可是英文哈 ，Steven 老师刚刚举了很多例子，好像是，假如英文的话，不管是主格、受格怎么样，你只要是 what 什么，或是 who 或是 which， 那你原则上哈，都是要把它这个疑问代名词放在最前面。不像中文哈，中文它就是主词就放在动词前面，是受词就放在动词后面。英文是一律不管怎么样，不管任何一个，不管主格受格，通通就放在这个字首、句首或子句前面。
On the subject of relative pronouns, I feel we should take some time to clarify what is meant by a relative clause, as well as a relative pronoun.Basically, the idea is to take one clause and insert it into another, using one element that is shared between the two. So, for instance, a compound clause, this is the girl who won the book award, is actually a combination of two clauses. This is the girl won the book award.Or, this is the necklace which I bought last month, is a combination of two clauses. This is the necklace. I bought a necklace last month. The novel that you gave me is very interesting, is a combination of two clauses. You gave me a novel. The novel is very interesting.In each case, the two clauses have one word, one element in common. And in one clause, that one word is replaced by a relative pronoun.
好，这个蛮有趣的哈。那 Steven 老师现在就提到说是关系代名词。原则上哈，关系代名词是两个句子，然后他把两个句子它共同有一个词的话，他把一个就是怎么把两个句子合成一个句子，怎么把它插进去。那我们书上举的几个例子哈，像是这边讲说 This is a girl who won the book award， 这个女孩哈，什么样的女孩呢？她得到书卷奖，这个女孩得到书卷奖。那原则上这是有两个句子， This is a girl， 这是女孩，然后第二个句子是 The girl who won the book award，这个女孩得到书卷奖。那我们把这个两个句子哈合并起来，就把它这边原则上就是 the girl 这两个句子共同有的一个词就是女孩这个字，所以把它合并起来，怎么合并起来呢？就用关系代名词，这边是人，所以我们就用 who， This is a girl who won the book award， 这样子两个句子就合起来。那下面我们的句例子是说 This is the necklace which I bought last month， 这也是拆开来，原来是两个句子，像 This is a necklace， 这是项链，然后另外一个句子是 I bought a necklace last month， 我上个月买了一条项链。那这边共同有的一个词一个字就是 the necklace， 项链。那怎么把这两个句子合并成一个呢？我们就把它插进去。This is the necklace， 共同用的是 the necklace 这个哈，所以我们不重复。This is the necklace， 然后我们这个 which 重复的这个 necklace， 第二个就用 which I bought last month， 就用这种方法把它衔接起来，两个句子把它合并成一个句子。
You may notice.That most of the relative pronouns in English are pronounced and spelled just like the interrogative pronouns. There are historical reasons for this, and just as English grammar tends to move interrogative pronouns to the front of the clause, so are relative pronouns also typically normally movedto the front of whatever clause they belong to, wherever they may be coming from.
好 ,Steven 老师是在强调说哈，关系代名词跟疑问代名词 who, which, what, 都是一模一样的。那还有在强调一点就是说， 它一定要在子句的最前面。那我们这一周就到这里讲解结束，谢谢各位收看，下周再会。